To find the other end of this vent.
Shall I tell him?
Oh, I'll talk with him.
Didn't have to tell him the test failed. It's still in development. We're going to solve it.
Alta, I'm beginning to doubt it.
Will you stop saying that? Are you going to let years and years of work just go for nothing? Now, let's run another test.
Thank you. Where does the air vent come in from the alley? Who are you? This is government property. What do you want? Inspector Kovic, Special Investigation.
How dare you burst in here? Get that dog down. Get him away. This machine is worth millions of government dollars in 5 years of my husband's life.
What are you at? Little people. They must have come in this vent. They must still be in there. Good. We'll get them from the outside. I'm sorry to have been so abrupt. Dr. Franson, is it? Mrs. Franson? Sometimes the chase after the little people doesn't leave us much time for the amenities. My apologies, my identification.
That's quite all right, Inspector.
Sorry about the dog, but that machine generates a great deal of heat, and the animal could have been injured.
It could have more than just injured him, I'm afraid. The fact is, the machine is powered by internal bursts of radiation at 7-minute intervals.
Yes, come on. Come!
Internal bursts of radiation?
That means we'll be dead in less than 7 minutes if we don't get out of here.
Let's get this door open. First in 5 minutes and 20 seconds. Let's check the master panel. We haven't got much time. Got less than 5 minutes.
There's no doubt they were in there.
They didn't come out while I was here, sir.
Well, maybe they came out before we got here. I will try to pick their scent up further on down.
Pry this door open. Maybe the hatch will work if it's strong enough. With the man's sake, give me a lever and I'll move the worm.
All I want to do is move his door.
You and me both.
Velocity?
As calculated, correct.
Thermal pressure?
As computed, correct.
That's no use. It better be. Half our time is gone already.
I've already checked them, but I'll do it again. All indicators check out perfectly.
Let's see what the directional computer says.
Mm-hmm.
computer says we're wrong.
But you'll find the error. Logar will just have to give you more time.
And I won't accept it.
Nor will Franz. Will you, dear?
I want to see for myself. Let's run another test.
For almost 5 years.
Is there anyone else who could develop a project this far?
this far to failure? Our spaceship will be ready for launch next month, and this guidance system must be ready to be installed in it.
And if it isn't, it will be ready the next year, or the year after that. The problems of space cannot be solved in a day.
Commitments are made to be kept.
I promised my best efforts, nothing more.
You're right. You're right, and I'm sorry, Franson. But these dreams of ours, exploring Mercury, Venus, Earth, these delays make me impatient.
It will happen, Logar. I promise you it will. We'll live to see the interplanetary exchange of goodwill. We have much to offer the men of other planets, and much to learn.
Have you at least isolated the problem?
Yes, yes. Let me show you the master plan.
I can get us all out of here.
What?
I can get us back to Earth. I saw enough of their guidance system to know what's wrong with it.
Well, yeah, but how does that get us back?
Because that's where they want to go. With yours and Dan's help, I can modify their system enough to guide their spaceship to Earth.
We understand all that, Mark. But how does that get us back home?
We make a deal with the Giants. I fix their guidance system. They give us a free ride home.
You said make a deal?
Well, that's right. Why not?
Because, first of all, Mark, how do you know you can trust them?
After you left that test room, I heard them talking. Now, they're scientists. All they're interested in is scientific exploration. They're not interested in catching us.
Are you kidding?
Why not? Why can't we try it?
Because we'd be putting our head into the lion's mouth.
We do that all the time. Did Inspector Kobe come and corner the three of you today?
Oh, Mr. Fitzhugh, they got away, didn't they?
Yeah, well, sure we did, because we were lucky, and our luck's not going to last forever. Right now, we have a chance to get out of here, and I'm going to take it.
You'd be committing suicide.
I don't think so.
What do you mean?
And I don't care what you say, I'm going.
Okay, then cut out!
Go make your deal.
I intend to.
But I need at least two others to help me with the work. Now, who else wants to go?
I will. I'll take a chance.
That's you?
Yes. If we lose, it's better than dying every day.
All right. When you find out that you've walked into a trap, don't come running back here. I don't want any Giants trailing into this camp. You get that?
Let's get out of here.
All right, let's find those Giants.
I want you two to wait here. If I can't make a deal, or if there's any trouble at all, get back to the ship as quick as you can.
Steve!
You had a change of mind, then.
after these. You know, you might want to call us. Look, Mark, I brought you those myself because we got a little hot back there, and now that you've had some time to think it over, I thought we could talk some...
All right, save it. I know what I'm doing.
You know what you're doing, but the trouble is you're involving two other people.
You don't see any chains around their necks, do you?
Look, I think the two of you should come back with me because I think you're going to regret it.
Captain Valerie and I know what we're doing.
I can speak for myself, Monsieur. Steve, I came because Mark needed someone to help him. And because I'm sick and tired of running and hiding and living like an insect in this giant, grotesque world. You stay here, but I don't want to go back home.
Well, let's hope you make it. Anyway, they're the radios. If you get any trouble, you call us, and we'll help you if we can.
Mr. Wilson, go ahead and make your deal with the giant.
Look, I want you two to go back to the edge of the park and wait.
Why? A little while ago, you wanted us to wait here.
So I changed my mind. I'm going to go in and talk to them. When I make the deal, I call you.
Oh, come on, Mark.
Look, do it my way.
For 3 hours, everything. Mathematics, astronomy, physics. He knows more than we do. I tell you, Logar, he has the capability of helping us.
And what about his so-called deal about taking him back to Earth?
Why not? It's little enough to pay.
Well, it's against the law. Wasn't that SID man looking for the little people?
The needs of the Defense Department supersede the SID.
Well, I won't have it. I won't have my husband give 5 years of his life to this project and then let someone else walk off with the credit.
Shh. He's coming out.
I'm certain that I can modify this enough to do the job.
How long will the modification take?
48 hours after I bring in my two helpers, the job will be done.
Helpers?
I can call in two of my friends if it's still a deal to take us home.
Agreed. You have our word.
It's you. Come on in.
We'll contact the Defense Department for their approval.
Let me speak to Inspector Kovic.
If all the systems are off, I'm ready to start the modifications.
Well, before you do, I want to neutralize any possible residual radiation. The neutralizer is carried in superheated steam.
I'll close the door.
I'll get it, dear.
As I said on the phone, I don't want anyone to know that I called you.
It's our secret, madam.
Why, you're that same... Well, you're from the SID. What do you want?
I want them.
What?
I'm taking them now.
What do you mean? They're working here with the approval of the Defense Department.
That doesn't mean a thing to me. I take my orders directly from the SID. So you thought you gave me the slip this morning, and now you've walked right back into my trap.
Oh, just a minute. We will see what Logar has to say about this. Logar! From the SID. He's going to take away our little people.
Oh, no, he won't.
My orders are specific. To apprehend and deliver into the custody of state security all little people, whenever and wherever found.
And mine are from the Defense Department to keep them here.
Shall we leave it up to the Supreme Council?
Certainly. We can put a call in from the office. My dear Inspector.
Of course you can have them.
A simple agreement. I use them for my purpose, a few days at most, then turn them over to you.
Agreed. Know we were here.
Why ask me? Those SID men were here before looking for you.
She's right. Now don't worry. I made a promise I will keep my word. I'll release you before I hand you over to the SID.
Well, as usual, the Defense Department has carried the day. The little people stay with us.
Good. I'll go to work at once.
I trust the next test will be a successful one.
It will be. The little people know how to make it work. I'm sure of it. They know how to solve the problem.
And take the credit for which you're entitled. Oh, no.
What's the verdict?
The agreement stands.
Okay, let's get to work.
Now, look, it'll take a day or two to resynchronize the components inside the system with your master panel.
I understand. Let's start at once.
Come on.
What's the procedure?
Well, in effect, we're inside an electronic computer.
Shh.
Fitz, here you take the memory bank over on this side.
Valerie, you have the switching bank over there.
What do I do?
Well, the memory bank stores and computes all the information that's fed to it. Your job in the switching bank will be to switch that information to the rest of the guidance system. My job will be to coordinate the rest of it on the master panel.
Bothering you, isn't it?
What are you talking about?
Be honest, Steve. Dan's been kind of silent with you, hasn't he? Well,
if he thinks that Mark's right, that's his privilege.
I suppose.
Look, I heard what you said. It's not that I think Mark is right. It's just that I'm not sure.
Yeah. I'm not sure either. That's what's bugging me. But I do know every time I think of what Mark is doing, a warning bell goes off in my head.
I know what you mean.
Memory bank 0 to 1.
0 to 1.
Right. All right, switch bank A to B.
A. I'm sorry. I'm good.
All right, that's all right. No harm done. Let's try it again. A to B.
A. B.
A to B. Now we're out of synchronization on this bank. Tell them to take a break until I can find the trouble.
Martha!
Open that door!
Yes, dear.
That synchronization trouble. I found it. I'll have it fixed in a minute.
Yes, dear.
Can you shut the steam off?
I got an idea. Give me a hand, Fitzhugh.
Can I help?
Yeah. Let's get this off. Okay, let's get the other one.
Nothing.
But the panel shows back pressure on the steam line. What happened? Where are the little people?
I don't know.
What happened? What happened in there?
We need ice water.
What went wrong?
I'll tell you later. Right now, we need ice water for his hand.
Easy, Fitzhugh. It's going to be okay. We'll have some ice water in a minute.
What went wrong?
The back pressure blew out the inlet pipe. The neutralizer, which shouldn't have been on in the first place.
Just put it down.
To turn the neutralizer on. And she must have known we were in there.
I did turn on the neutralizer, but I did not know you were inside the NMR.
How could you be so careless?
I looked inside. I'm so small, I didn't see them.
I don't see why you had to neutralize the thing in the first place.
The test panel showed residual radiation. I was only trying to protect you little people.
Must be more careful.
I'm sorry, dear. I will be more careful. I promise.
It was a mistake. You must understand. You are so small, so hard to see. Will he be all right? Will he be able to go to work?
I don't know. His hands are very badly burned.
You will be able to get on with the modification.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about.
I'll give you all the help I can.
Well, I know where we can get some more help, but it has to be done completely on my terms.
Of course. Anything you say.
All right, I'll stay and continue to do what work I can by myself. Meanwhile, these two will go back and contact some others from our group and see if they'll give us a hand.
Of course, let them go.
But what about Logar? You can't let them go without official approval.
But the man with the injured hands, he's useless.
But what about the woman?
Well, we will have to keep one who knows what to do, of course. I will take it as my responsibility. Let them go.
What about Fitzhugh's hands?
I will give you some bandages for his hands. Come, Otto.
All right, it's up to the two of you to convince Steve and Dan to come.
If Logar's okay, why shouldn't they?
Certainly Frankson has proved that he can be trusted to keep his word.
Yeah, well, let's hope Steve believes that. Now remember what he said. Don't go to the ship. Call him first.
Captain! On the walkie-talkie frequency.
What?
I heard Mr. Fitzhugh on the monitors.
Fitzhugh.
Fitzhugh, come in.
Steve. We have an emergency message for you from Mark. May Valerie and I come to the ship?
No. Don't you come near the spaceship.
We must speak to you. We must see you. It's important.
Okay. Fitzhugh, meet me at the big rock near the outpost.
Roger, okay. Steve. Steve, it all worked out as Mark said. He can fix their guidance system.
What happened to your hands, Fitzhugh?
I burned them. I can't work with them. Mark and Valerie can't do the job alone. They need more help.
Meaning Dan and me, I suppose, huh?
Steve, they promised to take us back to Earth. I trust them.
I don't, so you can tell them.
Get down!
Go back to the spaceship and stay there. Go!
Looks like both dogs are after us.
Get the dogs away. We've got you trapped. Are you coming out? From the car. That's how to do it.
Choked to death. Let's get outside.
Steve will get away somehow.
Sure they will. Don't worry, Fitzhugh.
Coming. Coming!
Sir, two little people from Inspector Kovic.
Buck? Doc Wilson! Are these the two little people you were expecting to help you?
Yeah, I was expecting them, but I wanted to bring them in my own way. Why'd you tell Colby?
I told him nothing.
Someone must have.
Alpha?
Hold up. Someone was caught just to get his way.
Someone has to look out for your interests.
Run! Damn, wait.
There's nothing to be afraid of.
Let go, Mark.
Whatever I did for you.
Come on, then.
I know what's best for you.
How could you do it? Behind my back, reporting on me to Kobik.
It's a matter of survival. We or the little people.
Survival? When they were almost killed by the neutralizer? You did it on purpose.
It was an accident.
Alta! You are never to set foot in here again. Never. Dan, you don't have to hide.
Shh.
It was not my plan to capture anyone or to go back on my word. I will prove it. You are free to go. I wish to hold no one against his will.
Let's see, what did I tell you? Now, you don't need any more proof than that. Dan, listen, don't throw away this chance of getting back to Earth. Dan, you heard him. Now, was Steve right or wrong about trusting him?
Maybe he's a man who'll keep his word.
Of course he is. Steve was wrong. Dan, listen to me. We can do it for all of them. They're in no danger now. We can all reap the benefits if we can fix this giant guidance system. It'll get us to Earth. I know it will.
Can the two of us do it?
Sure we can. The modification was almost complete when the neutralizer almost killed us.
Please stay. Stay and help us.
Okay, Mark, I'll help.
Good. The two of us can finish the resynchronization.
Very good.
You'll have to handle both the memory and the switching bank. I'll explain the rest as we go along.
It'd sure be a lot simpler if we had someone else to help.
That they would have been back by now, unless... Well, unless they could have...
Spindrift. Spindrift, come in.
This is Spindrift. Is that you, Steve?
Right. Did you all get away okay?
Oh, yes. How about you and Dan? Aren't you coming right in?
No, not yet. They've got Dan.
Oh. Well... Isn't there something we can do? I mean, can we help in any way?
No, nothing yet.
I'm gonna wait for night. That way I'll have a better chance to get to him.
Now be sure to stay put. Is that understood?
Okay. Steve.
What?
Nothing. Good luck.
Okay, that's it. Let's get out of here and let him test it.
Delivering as promised.
I'm ready to test the guidance system. It'll be a theoretical flight from our planet to Earth.
If it works.
All out and door closed?
Out and door down and ready to test.
It proves out.
Branson, my heartiest congratulations. I can promise you the Space Engineering Prize. And for me, one step closer to a seat on the Supreme Council.
It works. You're on your way home.
You hear? That's all of us on the way home. We did it, Dan.
Very good. SID man had?
Now that they've served their purpose, it will be necessary to turn the little people over to Inspector Kubik. State security is quite right. You people and your planet are dangerous because of your technical superiority.
We had an agreement.
In you go. Now that you little people have furnished us with a guidance system to reach Earth, I'll take care of you all.
You can't do this.
I can and I will.
But the Defense Department and Supreme Council agreed. You agreed?
Agreements with little people mean nothing.
But that isn't fair.
I'll worry about the morality. You worry about the engineering.
Then I will inform the Supreme Council that I will not operate this guidance system. No one else has the know-how.
You do as the Supreme Council tells you to do.
We'll see about that. Looks like Steve was right.
Giants are no different than us. Some of them can be trusted and some of them can't.
Yes, yes, please. What you have never learned, Franson, is that although technicians make the world go around, they do not run it.
Assistant to the First Secretary, please.
Steve. I'm sure glad you came back. They're in the office.
Is he ready to go?
I think so.
But what about my agreement? Logar's word to the little people.
Wait a minute. Is there some way to destroy this guidance system?
Yeah, the destruct button.
Where, there?
Yeah.
Wait a minute, but... We'll make it back there someday, but it won't be in one of those ships.